Hello everyone, welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are covering question number 31 to question number 50. This is the part 3rd of top 400 MCQ of Code of Criminal Procedure 1973. Now question number 31. A metropolitan magistrate can award a sentence of imprisonment in default of payment of fine. Equal to the term of imprisonment which he is competent to inflict as substantive punishment, not exceeding half of the term. Here equal to the term, here half of the term. Imprisonment which he is competent to inflict as substantive sentence, not exceeding one third here. The term and imprisonment which he is competent to inflict as substantive sentence, and option D is here, not exceeding 1/4, this is important here, of the term of imprisonment which he is competent to inflict as substantive sentence. So the provision of this question is provided in CRPC section 30 provided in CRPC, which provide that if in the default of payment the person's punishment is extended 1/4 of punishment which capability of the magistrate, but the same provision is provided in CRIPC Indian Penal Code section 65 provided that if any person in default of payment, if that person is liable for the extension of the punishment 1/4 of total punishment of that offense. Like we take example of theft, the total maximum punishment of theft is 3 years. If anybody, the magistrate give the punishment of any person for 2 years and fine 5,000 rupees, in such person does not pay the amount 5,000. So in this case the magistrate extend his punishment 2 years plus 9 months. This 9 months getting from 36 months upon 4. Maximum punishment is 3 years. So here 36 upon 4 we get here 9 months. So 9 months. So answer is here option D. Question number 32. The imprisonment in default of fine shall be in addition and to a substantive sentence maximum awardable under section 29 without any specific order, shall be in addition to a substantive sentence only when a specific order to that effective bypass, shall not be in addition to a substantive sentence awarded by magistrate, shall be in addition to the substantive sentence awardable by subject to the upper limit of substantive sentence prescribed under section 29. So in this question answer is B here, shall be in addition of to the substantive sentence only when specific order to that effect is passed. Question number 33. In case of consecutive sentence on conviction, sentence on conviction of several offenses at one trial, there is one trial by the Metropolitan Magistrate, here Metropolitan Magistrate taking a trial, the aggregate punishment is, so shall not exceeding twice the amount of punishment which the magistrate is competent to inflict for single offense. There is a happening of several offense by a person, same person, so in that case the magistrate have a capability to twice of his punishment giving power. Question number, option B, shall not exceeding the amount of punishment which the magistrate is competent to inflict for a single offense prescribed under section 29 shall not exceeding the time amount of punishment in which the magistrate is competent to inflict a single offence shall not exceeding 14 year. So here answer is option A, not exceeding twice. Option A is correct here. Question number 34. The classification of compoundable and non-compoundable, compoundable and non-compoundable offenses has been provided. First schedule, second schedule, there is no option of compoundable. There is bailable, non-bailable, summon case, warrant case, the capability of which magistrate is trialable such a particular offense. So these, in this list, in this chart, there is no provision of compoundable and non-compoundable. Schedule second provide the various forms like FIR or other charge, summon and warrant like this, and so there is form, so this option is also not available. Section 320 of CRPC and 321 of CRPC. So option C is correct. 320 of CRPC provide the provision which offense is compoundable or non-compoundable. What is compoundable and non-compoundable? Compoundable offense is those offense where the party of the case is having the capability to withdraw their case. So question number 35. The offense other than those mentioned in section 320 of CRPC are not compoundable, compoundable with the permission of court, compoundable by the court of session, compoundable by the high court. So those offense which are not provided in the list of section 320 are not compoundable. Option A is correct here. Question number 36. Arrest means every compulsion or physical restraint, total restraint and complete deprivation of liberty, both A and B, neither A nor B. So here answer is option B. Arrest means total restraint and complete deprivation of liberty. Question number 37. A warrant of arrest is command, must be written, signed, sealed and issued by magistrate, addressed to a police officer, all of the above. So here answer is all of the above. So this provision is provided under section 70 of CRPC. Question number 38. The person can be arrested without warrant for securing attendance of accused at trial as a preventive and precautionary measure for obtaining a correct name and address, all of the above. So here answer is all of the above. Question number 39. Which of the following is correct? Magistrate cannot arrest a person. It is wrong. Magistrate have a capability to arrest. Private person cannot arrest. Private person also having capability to arrest. There is a proper provision in CRPC. Police officer can arrest. Yes, it is correct statement. Both A and B, no. So magistrate having a capability to arrest any person who committing any offense. So in section 45, according to section 45, according to section 44, magistrate having capability to arrest any person who commit any offense, according to section 44. A private person, yes, private person also having capability to arrest, but it is provided in section 43 of CRPC. But in case of happening of non-bailable offense and cognizable, such offense is cognizable offense. If these two conditions are found, the private person having capability to arrest as that person who happening such. And another one important point is, if any person is proclaimed offender and abscond from the custody of, so in that case the private person also having capability to arrest that person. Now police officer, the clear provision provided section 41, the provided the police officer to arrest any person without warrant and who committing the cognizable offense in the police presence of police officer, and police officer also arrest with warrant. So both are provision provided in CRPC. So here answer is option C, because these two also having capability to arrest. Question number 40. It is mandatory for a police officer to inform a person arrested the ground of arrest and right of bail if offense is not non-bailable under sections 49, section 50, section 51 and section 54. So here answer is section 50. It is mandatory for police officer to inform the right, this is the right of arrested person to getting information in which offense causes by him and police officer arrested upon such offense. So police office, duty of the police officer to provide the information why he arrest that person. So answer is here option B, section 50. Question number 41. A police officer arresting a person may carry out a person search of the person arrested as provided. They carry out a personal search of person arrested as provided. Section 50, section 51, section 54, section 56. So here answer is option B, section 51. The police officer conduct a search of a person who is arrested. Question number 42. Section 54 of CRPC provided for the medical examination of accused at the request of police officer. Medical examination of accused at the request of the accused. Option C, both A and B, neither A nor B. So here answer is option B, medical examination of accused at the request of accused. Question number 43. It is mandatory to produce a person arrested before a magistrate within 24 hours of his arrest under section. It is very important question. So here answer is option B, section 57. Section 57 provided that it is the duty of police officer who arrest that person to produce the arrested person before the magistrate within 24 hours, but this 24 hour exclude the traveling time. Question number 44. The proclamation under section 82 of CRPC can be issued against a person against whom a warrant has been issued. Thus a proclamation can be issued against the accused offender, surety, witness, all of the above. So here answer is all of the above. Question number 45. The proclamation requiring a person to appear must be published given not less than 30 days time to the person concerned, not less than 10 days time to the person concerned, not less than 20 days time to the person concerned, not less than 15 days time to the person concerned. So here answer is 30 days, not less than 30 days after proclamation. The person getting the time of 30 days to produce, to present before the magistrate. Question number 46. Attachment of property of the person absconding can only be issued after publication of the proclamation under section 82 of CRPC. Can be issued before a publication of proclamation under section 82 of CRPC. Can be issued simultaneously with the issue of proclamation under section 82 of CRPC, all of the above. So here answer is option C. The magistrate have a power to issue the proclamation as well as attachment of the person, absconding person. And there are some specific provision under section 83 which provided that when the person who is going to dispose of this circumstance is available at the time where the person is dispose of the property. Another one point is there, remove the property. Remove the property from the jurisdiction of the court. In both conditions, the magistrate having power to issue the proclamation as well as same time simultaneously produce the attachment of property, order of the attachment of property. Question number 47. The period of limitation for filing claims and objection to the attachment of any property attachment under section 83 of CRPC by any person other than the proclaimed person as provided under section 84 of CRPC. Section 84 provided that the relation of the other person to the attached property, if any person having any right or interest in the attached property, he has a right or capability to claim their rights within the 3 months of attachment, 6 months of attachment, 1 year of attachment, and 2 months of attachment. So here answer is within 6 months of the attachment. The 6 months of attachment, the person here the power to file a suit within the 1 year under section 84, but he have capability to claim their rights under section 83 where the property is attached. So here he have power to claim their rights within 6 months, and if his claim is rejected, he filed the suit within 1 year. 1 year from the date of rejection claim. Question number, so answer is yes, B, option B, 6 months. Question number 48. The period of limitation for filing a suit to establish the right over a property attached by a person other than person proclaimed and who have filed the claim and objection to the attachment. So 3 months from the date of disallowing the claim, 6 months from the date of disallowing the claim, 1 year from the date of disallowing the claim, and three years from the date of disallowing the claim. So here answer is option C. 1 year from the date of disallowing the claim. Question number 49. If the person proclaimed appear within the period specified is in the proclamation, the property attached shall be released from attachment, shall be forfeited, both A and C. So here answer is option B, shall be released from attachment. If the person proclaimed appear, the proclaimed person is appeared, the proclaimed person under section 82 is appear before the magistrate or court, in that time his property is released, which property is attached under section 83. Question number 50, final question of this video. If the proclaimed person does not appear within the time specified in the proclamation, the property under the attachment shall not be sold until expiry of 6 months from the date of attachment, shall not be sold until any claim or objection under section 84 have been disposed of, both A and B, neither A nor B. So here answer is both A and B. If the proclaimed person does not appear within the time specified, the proclaimed Proclamation and the property under attachment. Proclamation and property under attachment shall not be sold until the expiry of 6 months from the date of attachment. First point here, and not be sold until any claim or objection under section 84 have been disposed of. So in 84 there are two points important. First one is the person having other person having capability to arise their claim within 6 months, or if his claim is rejected or disallowed, he may institute a civil suit in that time. The limitation is 1 year from the date of disallowing. So thank you for watching this video. Please like, your like is motivate us, and thank you for watching. Please share this video to your friends and relatives. Thank you.